do you think the blockchain could improve the innovation process?
To solve innovation, we need to build connections across groups. And the way that we structure the world right now is in these siloed entities, these centralized institutions, which makes it much harder to communicate across these closed groups. But the idea about having control of my data and being free to be able to express myself and having control breaks us out of that. So the blockchain as a platform around which individuals can now connect with each other across wider groups and across borders means that innovation can be unleashed. So I see the blockchain as a platform for innovation. I think it's a way to imagine how you can unlock ideas. And in a country like Brazil, which has this wonderful diversity of its population, has some very smart people, but has some very structured, centralized controls of information and controls of business, this is an opportunity to really unlock all of that energy that can come from that. Because once I have the confidence that the information that I'm imparting, that the activities that I'm undertaking can be done so in a way that we all can trust, that I'm not being exploited because I have control and a centralized institution isn't controlling it, then I can comfortably communicate, then I can comfortably do business, then I can comfortably enter into new commercial arrangements.
You mentioned Brazil. How do you think blockchain could try to make government difference or to improve it in another way?
So Brazil right now faces a crisis of confidence, it's fair to say. It's been a very long, difficult period where there's been a loss of confidence in the management of government. So there's concern about corruption, there's concern about a lack of accountability. And the bottom line is that, yes, there needs to be some resolution of those who are guilty, and there's been a process of cleaning that process up. But now the thing is, how does Brazil move to a point where it can prove that it is transparent, that it is accountable? And the idea about this technology is, again, it's a platform. It's a platform in which you can generate trust. Because, for example, you could place government procurement, government expenditures could be placed into a blockchain environment. There could be periodic recording of each component of the construction contract on a bridge, for example. And we could see who's getting paid at what time and whether or not the money that was dedicated to this fund or that fund is actually going to where it's supposed to be going.
Some governments feel threat about blockchain revolution. What do you think about that? How would be your answer?
So governments, I think it's natural that any institution will feel threatened by this technology. So governments are indeed feeling threatened, but so are banks, so are large public utilities. Any institution that at the moment has a certain amount of control, and all power comes from control, is going to feel somewhat threatened by a system that is inherently designed to get around that, right? So I think it's natural that a government will feel threatened. On the other hand, I also think that it's a new way to imagine how you can unlock value for your citizens. And so I think a government that thinks outside the box, a government that is being experimental and excited about this process, would recognize that this is a platform that allows its citizens to have more control over their futures. And so there's and I think that to the degree that there is a loss of control can be offset by a recovery of value in the sense that people will build and grow. You know, taxation, for example, could become more reliable because there is now a much clearer check on that money. Digital currencies that are issued by central banks could become far more effective in managing monetary policy because there's so much more information about that, right? So it's also a tool for empowering government as much as anything else. It's just that the existing structures and the existing bureaucrats are probably going to feel threatened because their models are going to be blown up.
One example is Estonia.
Estonia is one of the most forward-thinking governments in the world when it comes to digital technology. They're exploring a whole host of different ways to engage with people. So Estonia is an example of a country that I think is reimagining its relationship with the citizens. They are exploring blockchain applications, they're exploring e-voting, they're exploring e-residency, which exists outside of Estonia, and you can become a resident of that country even if you don't even live there. And these ideas, which kind of treat the role of government as a service provider and uses technology to make the delivery of government a considerably more efficient and reliable service, and so that your customers, your citizens are your customers, right? They are feeling like they are being serviced. That is a positive feedback loop. You have positive citizens, you have positive foreign investors, you have money, and you have economy, and you have innovation that all comes with that.